Vehicle Administration, this is Gina speaking. How may I assist you?
I was just returning the call that was on my missed call. This is Frank Garrett. How are you?
I'm good. How are you, Mr. Garrett?
I'm okay.
Good. Mr. Garrett, do you happen to have a file number that I can assist you with by chance? Because I don't make any outbound calls. I wouldn't know who called you.
Yes.
Okay, I'm ready when you are.
I wish you fucking niggers would go back to Africa.
Okay. Well, I'm not black, and you're racist, so bye. We don't speak to racists here, sir. Have a good day.
Chattanooga Police Department, can I help you?
Sir, this is the police department in Medford, Oregon. Did someone just call you?
Excuse me?
Did someone just call you?
Someone asked you to call me?
Okay. We keep receiving calls from someone who's irate, yelling at me, and he keeps calling back, and I put him on hold, and then when I came back from the number, you were on the line. So I don't know.
I was on the line.
Do you have a jail facility that somebody could be coming calling from that number?
I don't know what's going on with him.
Okay.
But he's called here.
And you think it's a friend of yours doing that?
I don't know who he is.
Saying that we're harassing him, and he's called 3 times now.
He's called you 3 times?
That's me. Hope your mama gets
Hello?
Stuck and your daughter too.
Sir?
Who's this?
What did you say?
Who's that?
I'm
now
sorry,
he's talking. I can hear him talking.
My name is Terry. I'm with the 911 center. You called 770-4784. Now, are you harassing me?
Bring your black ass down here and see what I can see.
Sir?
Did you hear what he said?
Hello, Ashland Police.
We're like on a three-way call now.
Okay, and your first name again was
Southern Gold. I'm at Southern Gold Jewelry in Chattanooga, and he's called here and cussed out my salesperson and cussed me out just a minute ago. And the phone rang again. I answered it, and then you answered it, and then he popped in again and started talking that you know what again.
What's your address so I can send an officer over there?
I'm over at 5307 Brainerd Road in Chattanooga, Tennessee.
Okay, and your first name again was what?
He's calling here. He started out cussing me out because he said I called him on a Sunday, and we don't even open on Sunday. And then he called again, and we answered the phone, and then you said you're in Medford Police Department?
Hey, I heard you.
Is that you said?
Oh,
well, there he goes again. Can you hear him?
Give me your address.
Can you hear him?
Give me your name and address and see what happens.
Can you hear him?
I don't call you anyway.
Hello?
And you're the goddamn stupid bitch.
Claims in process, and this is case manager Thomas Hines. How can I help you?
And your name's asshole.
My name is Thomas, last name Hines, H-I-N-E-S. Is there something I can help you with?
Yes, sir.
How can I help you?
Let me tell you something, bitch. Don't call back.
Watch your mouth.
Fuck you, bitch.
Anything else? You want to be an adult? Call back. If not,
how big a chair do you have to get to sit in?
Erie Delta.
Listen, you nigger-loving son of a bitch.
What?
You quit calling me, goddammit. You want another
son of a bitch, country motherfucker. Fuck you.
Do what?
You faggot bitch.
Mediation Services, Jacob speaking. How may I help you?
Hope your mama gets fucked and your daughter, too.
This is what you choose to do on the phone?
Yes.
Are you a man or a girl? You're a fucking girl. Little girls talk like that. Little girls play on the phone.
Oh, hell, you're
faggot.
Just a baby.
And
I'm 72.
Shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up.
And fuck you.
Idiot. Fucking dimwit.
I know you are.
Should have went to high school. You should have graduated school, you fucking dimwit.
Well,
instead of playing on the phone. Shut the fuck up. Didn't I tell you to shut the fuck up? You do what the fuck I say, fuck boy.
Mm-hmm.
Shit.
Nice
shut
now.
The fuck up.
Go fuck yourself, nigger.
Oh, there we go with the nigger. Oh, we're saying nigger now. Oh,
you know
we're saying
what?
Nigger now. Oh, you love the word. Say it again.
You don't have enough money to buy a fucking
nigger. No.
Baby.
Say it again. I want you to say nigger. I need to hear it. It gives me power. You dimwit. We only use that word as a vice to whoop your ass. We could legally whoop your ass if we see you on the street and you say that shit.
Nigger
That's
lover.
The only reason why we allow. You say it again. Say
nigger
it again.
Lover.
Knowing good
nigger
and well,
lover.
You will never leave your house. You will never leave your house and say that to anybody's face.
Then
that's what cowards don't do.
No,
shut up. Listen, we only use it as a vice to whoop your ass. That's it.
No,
we don't. It doesn't affect us anymore.
Court.
How do you know that it doesn't affect us anymore? Because we say it to each other all motherfucking day. But we don't like you to say it because you think it has an alternate meaning. No, it means beat the motherfucker that just said it ass. If
that's
he's not
black.
That's all it means. That's all it means. So, unless you will never say it outside, so you better stick to saying it on the phone. Stick to saying it on the phone. You look better saying it on the phone, okay? Nigger.
Hurry up. I'm gonna take your dick out, cut it off, and stick it in your goddamn old lady's ass and sew it shut. Nigger lover.
Hello?
I'll fucking goddamn rape the old lady and stick a goddamn white baby up in her fucking nigger pussy, and then I'll beat her like a goddamn redheaded stepchild and then have her sent off to jail. Because I'm going to kill you fucking kids. I'm going to make you watch it.
Take the dick out your mouth. I can't hear you. Take the dick out your mouth.
Tell you what I'll do.
What did you say?
You know what, nigger? You don't have enough money.
Nigger? What's up, nigger?
Frank Garrett.
How may I help you, nigger?
Frank Garrett.
What's up, nigger?
What nigger?
Well, hell, you're just a baby. I'm 72.
You're 72?
That's what I said, yeah.
Yeah? So what is your 72 ass doing playing on the phone? Shouldn't you be playing Parcheesi or Bingo or some shit?
Nope.
All right, so what are you going to do with your day-to-day? Fuck
with us? You don't tell me what to do.
I don't tell you what to do, nigger. I do tell you what to do, nigger.
You know something? You stupid bitch.
What, nigger? What do you want, you nigger-loving son of a bitch?
You know, you don't need to quit your day job at the pawn shop.
What do you want, you nigger-loving son of a bitch?
What do you want?
The fuck
do
you want, nigger?
What do you want, you stupid motherfucker?
I don't know, nigger. What do you want, nigger?
Look, asshole, what do you want?
What are you calling me, nigger?
What do you want, you ignorant son of a bitch?
You ignorant. Spell ignorant. If you can spell ignorant, I'll let you call all day.
You've been calling for about 6 or 8 times.
Spell ignorant. Can you spell ignorant?
Nope.
I'm sure you cannot.
I don't know.
Nope. What'd you say, nigger?
I'm glad you went that far in school.
What, nigger?
I can't even read.
I know you can't. Because you're
can
from
read.
Georgia. You don't have anything to do. I'm surprised you could dial a phone number.
You can read, can't you, you dumb motherfucker, you?
Claims in process, and this is case manager Thomas Hines. So can I help you?
Go fuck yourself, nigger, motherfucker.
You calling on another phone, you motherfucker?
Yes.
Why are you playing on a phone? You playing
on
single?
I don't know.
You probably
I'm
got
scared.
A small penis. You probably got a small penis, and you mad at the world because you
That's
got a
exactly
little
right.
penis.
That's exactly right.
You old as fuck.
Well, hell, you're just a baby. I'm 72.
You 72 old motherfucker.
Yes.
You shouldn't be on this phone playing on the phone.
You don't tell me what to do.
And we called you. We called you so we know who the fuck you is. And
do
I'm going to flood your number. I'm going to put your number on Craigslist and let them know that you suck little boys' dicks since
you're playing
on the phone.
I'm scared to death.
You're
not
sucking
any. Ooh, scare me to death.
You about to die, motherfucker, and you playing on the phone.
You don't frighten me.
Saying racial epithet, you faggot. You stupid motherfucker.
Go back to school and learn something, will you?
You stupid motherfucker.
You pink-lipped black son of a bitch, get off the phone.
I'm proud to be black, motherfucker. You red-faced faggot.
Well, I don't give a shit.
I don't give a shit.
I know you don't give a shit. You probably got an old-ass pickup truck. You probably live in a trailer, motherfucker. When you hear the beep, beep, get that house off them bricks, bitch. You mud-wrestling piece of shit.
I don't even have a Dodge. I drive Ford. But where I don't want that friend to hear you got that truck.
Tobacco-chewing, redneck duck dynasty, motherfucker. Fuck you.
Claims and processing, how can I help you?
I'm gonna fucking shoot your fucking brains out, you prick.
Triple R, this is Deborah.
Hello?
Triple R.
Hello? How are you?
Hello?
No, I didn't call you, dipshit. You called me.
Fuck you.
Thank you for calling Georgia Poison Center. This is Shannon. How can I help you?
I'm scared.
I'm sorry?
I'm scared.
Hello? Georgia Poison?
Hello?
This is the Georgia Poison Center. What can I help you with?
This is Frank Garrett. I'm scared.
You're what?
I'm scared.
You're scared?
Yes.
Okay, what are you scared about? What can the Poison Center help you with?
I don't know.
Then I would suggest call 911. They may be able to help you out better than I will if you're scared.
I'm scared.
Call 911. Okay.
Hello?
Hang up with us and call 911.
Ma'am.
Call 911, sir.
Hello? Hello?
Yes.
Hello, will you listen to me?
Yes, all I kept hearing was that you were scared. Yes.
This
Go
is
ahead.
Officer Hart from the Pittsburgh Police. This is the Pittsburgh Police.
I'm sorry, the Pittsburgh Police?
Yes.
And Pennsylvania?
Yes.
Okay, well, you got Georgia, so you might want to get, I can't imagine that, if you got a Georgia cell phone and you call 1-800 number from the Georgia cell phone, I'd suggest calling the 1-800 number from a landline, but you got the Georgia Poison Center. And this is
I don't know that to be true, so that don't mean nothing to me. Ma'am.
And you're not the policeman if you're not understanding what I'm saying, sir.
What you're doing is illegal. If no one has called from this place of business and harassed you, ma'am.
This is the Georgia Poison Center.
Would you like to give me a call at my police station?
No, this is the Georgia Poison Center, so I'd suggest that if you need the Poison Center to call the 1-800-222-1222 from a landline, or I can connect you to, are you trying to get the Pennsylvania Poison Center?
No. You're still going around my question.
What is the question?
Hold on, I'm going to put my boss on the phone. Hold on.
Okay. Yeah, if somebody can just give me a question, I might be able to help.
Hello.
Yes.
This is Frank
Shannon
Garrett.
At the Georgia Poison Center. How can I help you?
I was just returning the call that was on my missed call.
Okay, and you got a call from what number?
You.
Well, we have several numbers that are tied into poison centers. So if you can just read back the number that called you.
Okay. My number is 918-696-2788.
No, not your number. Not your number. What number was it that called you?
816-836-0538.
Okay, yeah, that's not our number, so I'm not sure how you ended up getting to
this
the Georgia
Poison Center.
This is Angela.
Can you hear
center?
Me? Can you hear me?
Yeah, are you the third person I'm talking to? Are you
yes.
the third person? Can,
okay.
I'm not sure who.
Look, you got a third party calling going on here, okay? I am the third party.
Okay.
I can't hear the third party.
Okay.
Hello?
Okay.
Okay, and now
yes,
tell me what's going on.
The Georgia Poison Center. How can I help?
Okay, and now tell me what's going on.
I don't know
Hello?
If you guys called us.
Let me tell you from
called
the beginning.
Us.
30 minutes ago, the phone rang.
Uh-huh.
Okay?
Okay.
I got the Sheriff's Department on the line, and I got a third party on the line. Do you know what I mean when I
okay.
say a third party?
Yes. Yes.
there is someone trying to get a hold of the sheriff's department that is coming from my room.
It's coming from where?
I don't know what's going on. I got Polk County Sheriff sitting out here in my parking lot.
I have no idea what's going on either, but somebody called the Georgia Poison Center, and I am just trying to figure out if somebody has a poison question.
That is fine. Yes.
Okay, what is the question? What can I help you guys with?
Here's Officer Powell. You can talk to him.
Oh, my goodness. Okay, yes. Please.
Okay, who is this I'm talking to right now?
This is Shannon at the Georgia Poison Center. Somebody called the Georgia Poison Center, and I'm just trying to see if there's any way I can help you out from a poison perspective.
We're trying to see who's this individual that's calling the station here.
Oh, I have no, and it came from a 1-816 number?
We just had several phone calls from this number, okay? And the individual, and we're leaving lewd and lascivious phone calls. He was saying how he wanted to have sex with the officers, and he also had other things that was threatening the officers. That's why we were able to contact this number and call this individual right back.
Okay. So tell me what number called you guys. What is the number that called you guys? The 816 number?
Is this a joke? I know this has got to be a joke because I didn't call nobody's house.
Somebody tell me what number called the station, and I'll say if it's our number or not. Somehow you got to the Georgia Poison Center.
Zero,
we are not
zero.
An 816 number.
People call crank calls all the time doing this stuff, but look, I didn't call you, so you don't forget that cursing and screaming.
Yeah. Now, this is a place of business, so I'm not sure what number kept calling the police station there or the sheriff's office there. But the number, somehow it's rolling back to us, but I was just trying to, is it the 816 number that kept calling the police station?
I'm sorry, the phone broke up. What did you say?
What was the number that kept calling the sheriff's office?
Every time you talk nasty, I get turned on. Go ahead, baby. Give me some more. I'm drinking on my tea, baby. Y'all have to excuse me. It tastes so good.
He was saying how you wanted to have sex with the captain, and he was saying how you wanted to have sex with the lieutenant here.
I'm just trying to find out what the number was that called the station to see if it's our number at all. What's the number that called the station?
This is the Cleveland Police Department, District Number 3, sir.
I bet you one thing, you see me, I bet you want to fuck, and I'll drag you across the floor like a dog.
Okay, this is Shannon from the Georgia Poison Center.
I'll sit on your head and piss in your face.
Because I'm going to disconnect. This is Shannon from the Georgia Poison Center. I'm just trying to find out what the number was that kept calling the police department.
816-836-0538. I live at 11216 Burton Street.
Not the Georgia Poison Center. I'm not sure why it's getting routed to the Georgia Poison Center, but our number is 1-800-222-1222, or here in Georgia, it's 404-616-9000. But we are not affiliated with an 816 number at all here in Georgia, so I'm not sure how it got routed to us in Georgia, but it looks like it's because somebody's calling from a 706 Georgia cell phone number. Like somehow, yeah, so for some reason you're calling, maybe the police department can call the 816 number themselves and just take the third party out of it and see where it takes you. But for some reason, if you're getting routed to the Georgia Poison Center, and that 816 number was not a number of ours, so the call did not come from us.
How come my phone rang? Is that accidental?
So I'm going to disconnect because you guys called us for some reason, but we are not, have nothing to do with that callback. Okay?
Why did my phone ring if you didn't dial my number?
I'm going to let you hang on with the police department there and disconnect because this is not a Georgia Poison Center situation. So we are not affiliated with an 816 number whatsoever.
Yeah,
so I'm going to disconnect.
I think you're
okay.
Kind of pulling my leg, buddy.
I'm a quarter blood onion, and I ain't want no onion blood in me. And I got a quarter blood African blood, but I don't have the nigger blood in me, but I'm going to get me a ding dong. And
are
I'm
you
make
still
it
on the line with us?
Yes.
Is the sheriff still on the line with us? Hey, I'm going to disconnect and let you guys figure out. Maybe somebody in the sheriff's department can actually call the 816 number from their own phone, and maybe you'll get someplace. But I think the whole third-party thing is taking, bringing you to the Georgia Poison Center, and we, the 816 number is not affiliated with us here. So maybe you guys can do a little more investigation from your end, from a landline, okay? Maybe you'll
now
get
you said you're a who,
else,
sir?
But the third-party thing is throwing this thing up.
Now, you said you're a who, sir? Now, you said you're a who, sir?
Me? Hello? I'm a ma'am, and I'm calling from the Georgia. You called the Georgia Poison Center, which is not affiliated with this 816 number that you guys are trying to get into. So I'm going to disconnect. You got too many people online, okay?
I'm sorry, what? What did you say?